Our Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler walks us through why the year looks to be groundbreaking.
The new ULA Vulcan rocket on its first launch, another Axiom All commercial mission to the International Space Station, SpaceX resupply mission to the ISS, and the launch of a lunar lander. A busy launch schedule for the Cape, and that's just January. Highly anticipated that 2024 will shatter launch records.
Next year is going to actually blow away 2023. It's not just going to be a little bit more cool, because next year we're expecting to see over 100 launches.
And in those launches, large steps forward for spaceflight. The first mission with astronauts for Boeing's Starliner. Along with Vulcan, Blue Origin's New Glenn is set to launch later in the year for the first time. The company looking to compete with SpaceX and ULA for orbital missions. Yes, new types of rockets, even new launch pads will play big in 2024 as new territory is cut. But also more people will launch to space from the Cape than in recent years.
Next year, we're going to see the most astronauts put into space in one year since 2009, since back when the space shuttle was in its heyday.
Next year's shaping up to be historic, but not easy.
We're going to see growing pains. We may see delays. We may see some launch failures. But as new rockets and new systems are launched from here, in the end, it'll really improve our overall capabilities.
A year that could start to change the way people think about space travel.
Maybe I worry at some point in the future it does get old, but that's okay because we've probably done our job and we've made space just a normalized mode of transportation, and it's just like air travel, sea travel, road, rail.
At the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.